I've never really had as much problem with one kanji as I have today, and hopefully it stays that way. But alas, I think I've gotten it. And trust me, it's important. Let's get on to it. Rightio, what's going on, everybody? We have some Bleach news, which I think is quite interesting and kind of brings on like a two-part special, because again, I eventually do want to talk about doing a Bleach roadmap and seeing where my mouth stops being really moist, where we get to kind of speculate on the least amount of time and the most maximum amount of time we're going to have for Bleach content going on in the future, taking many different things in consideration, X, Y, and Z. So this kind of helps towards that. And it's very interesting because we get about two different things today, which is really cool. So first off, being, let's talk about the Thousand Year Blood War arc, because I think it's important to start off with that rather than getting people gassed right from the start. And that is in fact filler in anime. Now of course we all hate filler, but in this case we kind of want it because there's many different things within the Thousand Year Blood War arc which, you know, we kind of expected, you know, a lot of fights being extended. But then again, in most anime anyway, we get like extended fight scenes unless you record a Ragnarok. But memes aside, I mean, yeah, everyone kind of expects anime fights to get extended, but we kind of want, you know, in canon story parts of the series to get extended, such as, you know, will we get the Thousand Year Blood War arc flashback of what happened all those years ago? And I, for one, hope that we do. I think giving an answer like that, if Kubo really addressed it right now, would be a big spoiler and, in fact, high anticipation. So I think, you know, if anyone has asked Kubo those questions, probably not going to get an answer to it, much like the question of what does Ichigo's Bankai do, because I do think those are things which are being kept secret and maybe will be addressed, whether that's in the manga later on or whether in the anime. So if you are asking those questions, guys, I mean, by all means, carry on asking those questions, but you know, you have to expect that maybe you won't get that answer. But regardless, in this context, we're going to get something which has been confirmed, that in fact Rukia, we're going to see the Sturm Ritter that basically slashed her at the very start of the war and incapacitated her when Byakuya got absolutely destroyed by Aznot, along with Renji as well. And many people are saying that this was Aznot anyway. Aznot was the one that hit Rukia and slashed her and basically buried her to the ground. And to which, like, even though that may seem like the case, and you know what, if you want to believe that, or if you think that that is the case, then you're justified to believe so. But when I look at the panels, my interpretation anyway is that it looks like, you know, Rukia gets slashed and then it transitions over to Renji versus Aznot. So I don't think it was Aznot that hit Rukia at that specific moment in time. However, if it was, it would be a nice little callback to when she does fight him. So maybe it is, maybe it isn't. Again, I'm interested to see. Regardless, if it is Aznot, then again, I'm still going to be interested nonetheless. And to get those, you know, extended scenes of that happening maybe goes to show more of a threat level that is maybe not so much prevalent in the manga, because in the manga it was supposed to be very ambiguous, it was supposed to be quite fearful, you know, all of this chaotic stuff is going on and we as a viewer weren't supposed to really know what was going on because everything was happening so quickly, right? And that's the concept of war. So in the anime it's going to hit a little bit different because again, everyone's kind of read the Thousand Year Blood War by now, and you know, you can add that music and that suspense and that voice acting along with it, so it'll probably have a better impact rather than kind of off-screening it. You know, it's a little change, granted. I think it's a little change depending on what they animate with that change, but again, it's a little change and I appreciate stuff like that because even the little things are getting more extension towards them, which is good because, you know, the big stuff that we want explaining, you know, maybe they're going to have a lot more time and effort in as well, as well as the fact as well, and I didn't make a video on this, Uryu and his grandfather are also going to have more context and more screen time to them in the anime too. So that again is even better for Uryu character and better for the grandfather, and hopefully foreshadowing more towards the arrow, etc, etc, even though I'm fine with the arrow because again, I guess I have my own little head canon or head cope about it that I could explain maybe before the anime comes out. That'd be really cool to kind of give my two cents on that. It was foreshadowed, granted it wasn't the best foreshadowing because it was like, it was very quick. It was like one panel type of thing and it just like, you know, it kind of got brushed off to the side. So no one really paid attention. But hopefully again, if they can, you know, attribute more to that, then I think that's great. You know, really good stuff for the Thousand Year Blood War arc coming at the moment. But what about after? Now, I know for a fact we've all been waiting for this for years upon years. This was the main topic of discussion. But now that we have it, of course, Bleach fans are going to push the goalposts. And I'm also one of them. Because we like to have things that we can't have. So what does this mean? Well, somebody asked the question of, you know, are the Bleach Gaiden books or the Bleach side story books, such as We Do Not Always Love You, going to get animated? And it was an interesting question, which was very specific towards Ruki and Renji's wedding, We Do Not Always Love You light novel. So the answer was directly towards the We Do Not Always Love You light novel. So don't take that away from Can't Feel Your Own World. And Kubo, this is where the kanji is quite annoying, because there's two translations towards this. The Google translation is more like, I see, if you have a scale, you can do it. A more correct translation I would more so believe in is, I see, I wouldn't mind doing it if I had the time. Now, the kanji here is shaku, and it's a bit weird because realistically, its kanji means measurement, a measurement of something or a ruler. However, there is a context which took me a while to learn, which was broadcasting time. So if you look at what it means in terms of broadcasting time, it could mean, depending on the length of the anime, depending on how long maybe TV Tokyo's contract is or Pierrot's contract is, or maybe the allowance of time from the animators and the director, depending if they're not booked on other projects, then Kubo in fact said he likes to do it. Now, that's interesting, because regardless of the length of time or X, Y, and Z, right, about, you know, whether the industry can do it or not, the fact of the matter is Kubo says he wants to do it, or he'd like to do it, you know. That's the main point of the situation. And you can't really have a Bleach anime without Kubo, because as we all know, Kubo is very heavily involved within the subject at hand. And I think they will do it. And the reason why I say that, and again, we can get into like really like, I guess, theoreticalness about this and say, oh, well, how long is Boruto going to go on for? Or is Black Clover going to come back? And will the studio have enough time to do Bleach? I don't really think it's relevant. I think if a series is popular enough, TV Tokyo will create that time slot. They will extend a certain amount of cause for a new season. And especially if the team's already on a project, you know, they probably, you know, they're probably going to be on this for a few years. And again, this is why you hopefully subscribe to the channel and see the timeline of Bleach anime content in the future, which I'll try to do relatively soon. Because yes, anime studios are fully booked, but we don't really know up until when and which studios particularly, and how much leeway you get out of those fully booked sessions and what that truly means. But the point I'm making is, and you know, Shueisha also promoting the light novels like crazy quite recently, you know, the official Shueisha account goes to tell me that if there is support for the light novels, then I generally do think they'll continue to carry it on. I've always believed that this is probably going to be a Dragon Ball like situation, where, because in Dragon Ball there is a 10-year time skip. It was 7 years, James, come on. I do believe that they will implement, especially if Bleach is really, really popular, Boruto will end at some point, and they can't keep using Naruto, right? And I generally think that they'll use Bleach as the next cash grab. Whether I'll agree with it or not is depending on the stories that they do. But again, if Kubo's interested in We Do Not Always Love You, you cannot do We Do Not Always Love You without doing Can't For Your Own World first, because Can't For Your Own World is 6 months after the Thousand Year Blood War arc, and then in 3 years after the Thousand Your Blood War arc is We Do Not Always Love You. So, you know, there's a lot of content, and then you have Hell too. So, you know, again, if Hell does well and Kubo comes back to do Hell chapters, I think it's already solidification that you are going to get more Bleach content after the Blood War arc. And I did find it interesting, and I will do another video on this as well, talking about if Hell is going to come back or if they can do more arcs, is the way that they mentioned Bleach's final arc, because that's a very interesting name to call it, because you can't call it a final arc and then do more. So my theory is that they're going to call Bleach something else, maybe after the Thousand Year Blood War arc. So like, you know, like with Naruto and then Naruto Shippuden, right? They're just going to name it something else. So that will be interesting to see where it goes. And again, we don't know how long Bleach is going to go on for. It could be 2 years, 1 year, 5 years, 10 years. You know, how much time has Pierrot been booked for? And that's what it all comes down to. So it is highly likely that the light novels will be adaptated, but it is important to, just as Nakano has said in one of the, I think it was the Bleach Jet, it wasn't like a press, was it a press release? It was like an event for the Bleach Jet art book. It says, support Bleach as much as you can and you will get what you want. Essentially, I'm paraphrasing. Nakano's a good man. If he wants it to happen, he'll make it happen. So, good news all round. Light novel adaptations, very much highly confirmed. And no, the thumbnail isn't clickbait, because if you make the Thousand Year Blood War massive, then you're the only reason, like, you as the fan base are the only reason stopping that light novel from being adaptated. So as long as you support it and watch it, and hopefully it's good and it isn't bad, then yeah, it's confirmed. So take that as you will. I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been a handsome, as I've said, subscribe for more content. I'm going to catch you more, folks, later. Peace out.